Imagine a computer thousands of times more powerful than the most sophisticated computer we have today. Now imagine that computer being small enough to hold in one hand. Impossible? Not if you regard the human brain as a computer. Now, take a superior humanoid brain. What capabilities would it have? How much knowledge could it hold? Consider the many facets involved in thinking and research, medicine, technology, and science. Perhaps it could run a city, monitor and control electricity, water, traffic, gas, all the resources needed to keep a metropolis alive, much as it keeps a body alive. Let's dissect Spock's brain. Gene Kuhn wrote this episode under his pen name Lee Cronin. And according to critics, it's the worst episode of Star Trek ever produced. Criticism has come not so much from the premise of Spock's brain being stolen, but from the way in which the story was handled. Now, rumor has it that Kuhn, who was constantly at odds with Roddenberry over show content, wrote this script as a practical joke, ribbing Star Trek for taking itself way too seriously. It just goes to show that practical jokes sometimes backfire. Well, thank goodness the Enterprise was able to retrieve Mr. Spock with brain intact. During this tough third season, we all felt that our characters were being compromised and stories were becoming more far-fetched than ever before. But as this episode proved, probably the character most maligned was Mr. Spock. Leonard felt betrayed, and many of us felt cheated, considering the hard work done by the entire cast throughout the history of the series. It just wasn't fair. And we blamed the network, you know, no one individual. Because of poor ratings, we were now being left for dead by the network. But that, as they say, is showbiz.